Yeshayahu, Isaiah 36. Now it came to pass in the 14th year of King Yekhi-Kiyahu that Kanhe-Iv, king of Ashshur, came up against all the defensed cities of Yehudah and took them. And the king of Ashshur sent Eth-Rav-Shechah from Lachish to Yerushalayim unto King Yekhi-Kiyahu with a great army. And he stood by the conduit of the upper pool in the highway of the fuller's field. Then came forth unto him Eliakim, Kilkiyahu's son, which was over the house, and Shivna the scribe, and Yoach, Ahab's son, the recorder. And Rav Shechai said unto them, Say ye now to Yekhi-Kiyahu, Thus says the king of Ashshur, What confidence is this wherein you trust? I say you, but they are but vain words. I have counsel and strength for war. Now on whom do you trust, that you rebel against me? Lo, you trust in the staff of this broken reed, on Mitzrayim, whereon if a man lean, it will go into his hand and pierce it. So is Pharaoh, king of Mitzrayim, to all that trust in him. But if you say to me, We trust in El Yahuwah Eloheinu, is it not he at whose high places and at whose altars Yekhi-Kiyahu has taken away and said to Yehudah and to Yerushalayim, Ye shall worship before this altar? Now therefore give pledges, I pray you, to Eth my master, the king of Ashshur, and I will give you 2,000 horses, if you be able on your part to set riders upon them. How then will you turn away at the face of one captain of the least of my master's servants, and put your trust on Mitzrayim for chariots and for horsemen? And am I now come up without Yahuwah against this land to destroy it? Yahuwah said unto me, Go up against this land and destroy it. Then said Eliakim and Shivna and Yoach and Rav Shechah, Speak, I pray you, unto your servants in the Aramith language, for we understand it. And speak not to us in the Yahudith's language, in the ears of the people that are on the wall. But Rav Shechai said, Has my master sent me to your master and to you to speak at these words? Has he not sent me to the men that sit upon the wall, that they may eat at their own dung and drink at their own piss with you? Then Rav Shechai stood and cried with a loud voice in the Yahudith's language and said, Hear ye at the words of the great king, the king of Ashshur. Thus says the king, Let not Yekhi-Kiyahu deceive you, for he shall not be able to deliver you, neither let Yekhi-Kiyahu make you trust in El Yahuwah, saying, Yahuwah will surely deliver us. This city shall not be delivered into the hand of the king of Ashshur. Hearken not to Yekhi-Kiyahu, for thus says the king of Ashshur, Make an agreement with me by a present, and come out to me, and eat ye every one of his vine, and every one of his fig tree, and drink ye every one the waters of his own cistern, until I come and take you away to a land like your own land, a land of grain and wine, and a land of bread and vineyards. Beware lest Yekhi-Kiyahu persuade you, saying, Yahuwah will deliver us. Has any of the Elohai of the nations delivereth his land out of the hand of the king of Ashur. Where are the Elohim of Hamath and Arpad? Where are the Elohim of Sepharvaim? Rather, Sepharvaim. And have they delivered Eth Shamoron out of my hand? Who are they among all the Elohai of these lands that have delivered Eth their land out of my hand, that Yahuwah should deliver Eth Yerushalayim out of my hand? But they held their peace and answered him not a word. For the king's commandment was, saying, answer him not. Then came Elachim, the son of Kilkiyahu, that was over the household, and Shivna, the scribe, and Yoach, the son of Asaph, the recorder, to Yachizkiyahu with their clothes rent, and told him at the words of Rav Shechai.